14 days ago, Uganda's indigenous pharmaceutical company, Cipla Quality Chemicals Industry Limited, offered to sell 18% of its shares to the public. The initial public offer period of 10 days was extended to 14 days, and this should have given a chance to Ugandans to bid for the shares that were going for 256 Uganda shillings.
A lot of offices were closed, especially in the city. Activity slowed down generally, and based on that, the authority made a decision to extend that window to allow for more investors to come on board.
As the public awaits for what they have been offered against what they bidded for, the Capital Markets Authority is optimistic that there was oversubscription.
Invested several million dollars in expanding the capacity of our facility in Luzira by 30%. So we can now manufacture 130 million tablets a month on a two-shift basis at our current manufacturing facility.
Going public is an opportunity that gives as many Ugandans as possible to hold shareholding in a company. And a company that has exhibited growth over the last 30 years.
What we are looking forward to now is the process of then allotment, which is done by the company together with the transaction advisors and the other people who are involved. Once an allotment is essentially what, like giving out the shares of you know, allocating the shares that people have bidded for.
Yes.
Because what has been going on is the bidding process.
In case Ugandans are not able to take up the offer, Cipla has the liberty to cross list in other markets, especially the vibrant Nairobi stock market.
I must emphasize that in the past we haven't had any under subscription for any IPO in the country.
Yes.
However, if it happened, there are many things that can explain that. To arrive at a cross-listing is a decision again of the company, and as a regulator, if you fulfill all the requirements for a cross-listing, we cannot deny you that opportunity.
Cipla joins other local companies, including the New Vision, Umeme, Uganda Clays, and DFCU on the Uganda Securities Exchange. Rebecca Manuel, reporting for Urban Television.